Some people learn their discipline from their parents. Some learn it in the military. Some learn it in sports. I learned my level of discipline in the penitentiary because the politics in the penitentiary are endless. You're gonna do it. That's why when you're out here and you learn to hold yourself to a high level of self-discipline, everything is possible. You're talking yourself out of everything you ever wanted. Everything. You don't have an alcohol problem. You have a fucking discipline problem. You do not have anxiety or depression. You have a discipline problem. You do not have eating issues. You have a discipline problem. Like Viktor Frankl said, between stimulus and response, there's that space, that space. That's where our power to choose lies, and that's where our life is created. When you learn to have a strong mental witness and identify that space as the powerful moment that will create the life of your dreams and stop being a victim to the circumstances around you, you realize it's all under your creation. It's all under your creation. I was in the worst place, but had the best mindset and was able to do what people can't do out here because they spent all their time on negative events, all their energy thinking up negative scenarios and not knowing that their energy is their most valuable resource. They're still thinking time is when it's not. Our energy is our most valuable resource, and we can only correctly use it when we have the discipline to put it in the right place. Fact is a lot of people just say, fuck it. Quit saying fuck it. It's something you really want. Why are you gonna lie to yourself? That's cognitive dissonance when you have two conflicting belief systems. It's craziness to inflict suffering upon yourself when you could just stay disciplined and grind and learn what I teach over and over. Learn that the greatest pleasure in life will come when you learn to not get your way all the time. When you learn to self-inflict adversity with intermittent moments of pleasure. The pleasure ends up being the goal that you were after that was way too lofty to begin with. And then you crush it. Massive level up. People talk themselves out of everything because they have a low level of stress management, which causes a bitch ass motherfucker to tap. Think about it. Why'd you tap on your diet, bitch? Why the fuck did you tap on your diet? You got stressed out. You thought you wanted the snacks more than you wanted the abs. So you tapped out. You stressed out about it. You said, I'm too hungry. I'm too hungry. I'm too hungry. And then you ate that shit. Why'd your relationship fail? You got too stressed out because the way the person was acting and you couldn't control yourself and get the right outcome. When you knew the right outcome, you knew the right solution. It was a golden rule all along. This person's struggling, pick them up. Love them back into character. When it comes to your business, what's keeping you from leveling up? Stress management. The stress management. But everything starts with the discipline. So when we discipline ourselves, when we run a daily program that I teach on here every day, when we run a disciplined daily program that's extremely detailed, we realize that we don't rise to our goals. We fall to the strength of our system. Our system builds our discipline. So when we're building discipline daily by getting up when we don't want to, by eating what we don't want to, by working out, by reading positive things, by collecting all these mindset hacks and these gems to negate the negotiation. Essentially, that space between stimulus and response is where we need those gems. We need those gems in that space so that we don't negotiate with our lesser self. When we learn to live in this manner, fully internal, the external world is ours. It's too easy because we're in control and we're drawing it in. The fact is when you're uber disciplined, when your discipline level is at a fucking 1 million out of fucking 10, everything is possible. You'll be as ripped, as rich, and as fucking mentally sound as you want to be. From no longer buying into the fact that perpetual pleasure chasing is a possibility for you. Because you know where it ends, not where you want to go. We end up living this life, this militant life in the penitentiary, where there is no way out. That's why I run my program like that. No days off. There's no days off from discipline. Yes, some of my clients, they just read, wake up early, and go about their day that fits their business schedule and all their stuff, but they make sure to push themselves daily. We're weathering ourselves with discipline. We're weathering ourselves for the storm. So when what someone supposedly calls a struggle is laughable to you, What you guys call a struggle is laughable to me. What you guys call pleasure is laughable to me. The guys on my team, they've learned it. They've learned to get pleasure in not being pleased. The stuff that they thought used to please them is laughable to them because they know there's just a downside. There's a massive spike, a massive high, followed by an extreme low that leaves them crashing. I did it over and over. I see the guys in the penitentiary doing it over and over. I can't even eat out of line with my goals because I feel like a bitch and I let myself down. When you have such a high level of awareness that you know how you're going to feel after you act a certain way, then your discipline just starts to grow. Discipline's the root. If you're disciplined enough, your anxiety and your depression don't exist. At that moment, when you're choosing to go in the past and be depressed about something that happened a while ago, you're disciplined enough to choose something in your current life and circumstances that you're grateful for. Choosing gratitude over depression. Choosing what you have in your life now to be grateful for over the past shit that you think you fucking want. You think you want. The same thing with the future. Going into the future and being anxious and letting it fucking run a train on your mindset. Or you can just get to action. Cross out anxiety, call it energy. It's not what we call it. These false definitions are foolish. And what I'm saying, why discipline is the root of curing depression and anxiety, is because right then you have the ability to choose something else to be grateful for in your life instead of creating this imaginary evil, this false situation, this scenario that's never going to take place to fuck your day off. All too often, a bitch-ass motherfucker wakes up, thinks too much, creates a false scenario that's not going to take place today, and then fucks his day off. I never do that because I don't give myself time to do that. If I sat around in the morning, I would do that too. But I just go straight into it because I know that I'm inherently negative. So I know I have to buy myself time with my positive acts. Going to the gym buys myself like 2 hours of positivity. Then I start to get negative. It starts to creep in again. Then I do some more push-ups and more burpees and I buy myself some more time. It's not only positive acts. It's not only physical acts. It's helping people. It's reading certain gems, certain quotes, certain passages and books that open you up again, that give you that fucking clarity. It's all this. Every positive act, every fucking act of personal growth, everything you're doing to develop your internal state better and change your external world for the greater, for good, everything you're doing is buying you time from that negativity that's coming. It's coming. There's a problem coming. There's an undesirable mind state coming. You're gonna step into it. We need the negativity and we need to overcome it. And you don't overcome it in that fucking bag. You don't overcome it in that bottle. That just makes it worse. That exponentially increases the anxiety and the depression. Keeps you stagnant and causes regression. Let's fucking get this shit dialed. We're coming to the end of the fucking year and some of you are still making the same mistakes you made last year while others are skyrocketing to where they want to go. Understand that tomorrow you're going to have the same problems as today. See the fucking signs and get it done. Let's go.